Hello everyone, welcome to Let's DevOps. I am Sumit and today we are going to discuss about how to set up a Jfrog Artifactory with GitLab CI/CD. For all the demo and discussion, I'll be following this article. You can find the link of this article in video description. So let's start. So first is introduction. So in this article, we will learn how to set up a Jfrog with GitLab. Further, we will build a Nuget package and we'll publish to the Jfrog Artifactory. Now let's understand what is Jfrog Artifactory. Jfrog Artifactory is package or artifact management tool which helps to share or store multiple versions of package or artifact. What is an artifact? When we build an application, we create a package with deployable files like DLL, EXE, WAR or JAR file. Further, that package we will use for deployment or sharing with other teammates. That package we call as an artifact. Now let's understand why we need a Jfrog Artifactory. In some case, when you need to share your package or artifact with other teammates or a project group or external group, then you need a Jfrog Artifactory for better package management. Coming to the use case, so in this scenario, we will set up a Jfrog Artifactory with GitLab, and further with the help of GitLab, we will publish the artifact to the Jfrog Artifactory. Now let's talk about the architecture. So in this diagram, if you see, we are using GitLab CI/CD, Git repo, we are using Jfrog CLI, and with the help of Jfrog CLI, we are going to create a NuGet package, and then we will publish to the Jfrog Artifactory. Now coming to the workflow, first we set up a Jfrog integration, after that we'll create a package, and then we'll publish the package to the Jfrog Artifactory. Now let's discuss each component one by one. So first is Jfrog integration. So now we will discuss here how we are going to integrate the Jfrog with the GitLab. So step one, we need to first log in to the Jfrog and then we create a repository. Assume that in your case, if it's already exists, you can make use of it. But I'll create a repository. So I have logged into my Jfrog Artifactory. And now I'll go ahead and create a repository. So I'll use the package type as a NuGet because I'm going to create a NuGet package and then I'll publish it. So NuGet. Okay, and here we need to provide the name. So I have added the register repository key as a SRS test demo, and then I will go ahead and create it. So now my repository has been created. So this is a SRS test demo. So currently I don't have anything in here and I have created this repository of the type NuGet. So assume that if you are creating for your Maven or NPM, you can just create with that particular type. Now let's go to the article. So step two says that we need to go and click on the repository and then we need to click on the set me up. So let me go there. So currently I'm setting up for this repository. So I'll just click on this and then I'll click on set me up. And here, if you notice, since I have selected for NuGet, it is coming for that repository only. And here I have some configuration detail. So basically we will make use of this configuration detail for integrating with our GitLab. So we need to use this, all the key details. And under deploy, I think this is for how you are going to push the CLI to push that to your packages. So let's first go and configure and then we will come to the deploy section. Okay. So step one says that we need to get this information and then we need to create a variable in a GitLab CI/CD. So since these are this has some secret information, we will create those variables. So currently you can see my all the secret detail, but after this demo, I'll be deleting this repository itself. Okay, so let's come here and then we need to set up three variables. One is the Jfrog source, second is Jfrog password, and third is a username. So once we set up this variable, we'll further see what we need to do. So let's first understand and create these different variables. So as per the instruction, I need to connect to my GitLab. So I have connected to my GitLab project And these are the three variable I need to create. So first is the JFrog source. So I'll copy this information and then I'll create the variable. So for creating a variable, you need to go to the setting and then CI/CD. And under the variable section, we need to expand it here and we need to add the variable. So this is the variable and the value you can pick it from here. So I think this is the source. Right, this is the source. Right, let's see how it is in here. Okay, now this is the source. So let's create this. Second is we have with the JFrog password. So let me create that. And then the password is this one. So this one, the value, so this mask variable, and then next is we have a JFrog username. Let's get the value. Sorry, I think I need to use that. Let me up, and my username must be this one. Right, copy. So now three variable we created as per the instruction. So next is that we need to set up a build pipeline. Okay, so step one says that include the Artifactory setup information received in the previous step in pipeline and see for example. So let's go to that our GitLab CI/CD pipeline. And then we will configure first to integrate with the JFrog, and further we will create a package and then we will publish it. So let's go to the project, and here if you see I have a sample solution file. So for this particular solution we will try to build, we'll create a package and then we'll publish to the JFrog Artifactory. Okay, so currently if you see in my repository and the artifact, I don't have anything, right? It's currently empty. So let's first set up the pipeline and then further we will create a package and then publish it. So let's go here and then edit this pipeline. So currently I don't have anything in this pipeline, so but it is currently tagged with my GitLab runner. So this is my runner information. So let's first go to that repository, and again let's go to the set me up, and here if you noticed we need to include this configuration, right, as part of this. So we need to just select this. Basically I'll copy this and here I'll paste it. Hello. Okay, but this is not a best practice to keep this secret, although currently I'm exposing my password, but I'll delete my the Artifactory, the package Artifactory after this demo. So and in the previous step we created a variable, right? So you can also use the same way. You don't expose your password or any detail through that through the pipeline, right? So I'll just remove this all information here, right? And then the password. So as part of the first step we need to provide the name of the source, right? So we created three variable, right? So first is this one, JFrog source. So here I'll add with the source and then the username. So I created this username, so this is $, and then the package is username, right? So first is this, and the second what we need to do, we need to add this information in your Nuget config. So in our case, in my case, we don't have, so I'll just go to the next step and then here I will set up this part, right? So here, and also you need to make sure that whether you have the Nuget installed on your runner. Okay, so here again, I'm exposing my password, so I'll just use this jfrog, and this is the password. So I will, sorry, here something is wrong, right? Password is wrongly configured. Okay, so I'll just copy this and put it in here, right? And this part should be here, dollar password, and this should be coming here, right? So with this in two CLI, we will be able to connect to that our Jfrog Artifactory with the this particular runner, right? Okay. Now next, what we need to do, we need to build an application, the sample application which already exists. So I'll just use this the command, this CLI, and I'll just add it here. So after setting this the configuration with the name of Artifactory, we are going to build this application, and then we will also create a package and we will publish to the Artifactory, right? So let me copy this. So you can make use of this, and so if you want to learn how to create a NuGet package or through that solution file, I have created another video. I will just put that link in that article. You can follow that. But this is how we create a NuGet package. So with this NuGet pack, it will create, and then while pushing it, we'll provide the name of our package, and then we'll provide the source. So this is the source which we created in the here. So with this Artifactory name, it will go and publish to the Jfrog Artifactory. So let's commit this change, and hope it would have already triggered the pipeline. So currently it is running. So the execution got successful, and here if you see, it says that this package has been pushed to this Artifactory. So let's go to the Jfrog and refresh and see whether we have the package available now. Okay. And here if you notice, the package is already uploaded, right? So I think that's all for this demo. Here we have some additional command that maybe you can use. That is for listing all your resources, and if you want to remove or add any new resource, you can just use these commands. Okay. Thanks for watching this video. I'm hoping this will be useful. If you have any issue or concern while setting up your Jfrog integration, you can let me know in the comment box. I'll be happy to help.